It's time for Ask the Vet. Dr. Courtney Campbell is here with Angela, who has a question about her beautiful dog, Essie Mae. Well, hi there.
Say hi.
So what's going on?
Well, I was told that Essie Mae has a luxating patella.
Okay.
But I've never seen any sign of it. Yes. And I don't know really what that means, how bad it is. She's very active. She loves to play ball. And I don't know, should I let her do things like that?
Sure, sure. One of the most important things I just picked up on what you said is, I've never seen any sign of it. Mm-hmm. That's really important because there's thousands, if not millions of dogs out there that actually have dislocating kneecaps, or what we call patella luxation. So let's back up for a second and really look at what it is first and foremost. On Essie Mae, here's a beautiful knee here, and what we're looking for, this is obviously your femur or thigh bone, here's the tibia or shin bone, and underneath that ligament, there's that patella right there. And for some dogs, if that shin bone is oriented to the inside, look where that kneecap is.
Yeah.
It comes off to the inside. If it's on the inside, that hurts. If it's on the outside or lateral, that hurts too. Okay. So it's gotta stay right in the middle like a bobsled, right? And just stay right in the groove every time they flex and extend. So let's take a look at Essie Mae and let's just feel, because there's different grades.
So does this then just get diagnosed if you go to the vet for your annual exam and as you go through the range of motion, you notice it?
And that's exactly what I'm doing right now. I can feel on the left. What we have is a grade 2 dislocating kneecap, and on the right side, a grade 1. Here's the difference. Here's the difference. A grade 2, it pops out, but I can take my finger and put it back in the groove. A grade 1 pops out occasionally, but it stays in the groove. Now, here's why it's so important that you said, I've never seen any sign of it, because that's how we determine whether a dog needs surgery or doesn't need surgery. She's 5, you've never seen any sign of it. I would definitely not say that she's in the candidacy for surgery.
Okay.
I would not do surgery on Essie Mae because she's not limping. So there's nothing that you can do to prevent it because that's the way they're born. But if they're limping, first and foremost, talk to your vet. They may have some conservative things like rest, anti-inflammatories, and then if that isn't working, like physical therapy doesn't work, then we think about actually correcting these bones. If it's off to the middle, we put everything back to alignment. The bottom line is, if they're not limping, then to me, you can't get better than perfect. And that's the bottom
line. Amen.
Yeah.
So true. And it also highlights why it's so important to get regular checkups
Absolutely.
With the vet.
Absolutely.
And to continue to monitor.
And that's
now,
the thing.
You did say about the, like, when it pops out.
Yes.
Do I ever have to pop it back in?
You never do, because it pops out occasionally.
Okay.
And then when she bends her knee, it pops right back in.
Good.
And that's exactly what it's doing. So most dogs, how do people know whether your dog has this? Most dogs will skip when they walk.
Mm-hmm.
They'll run, hold their leg up for a few steps, carry it, and then spontaneously put it right back on the ground. It's like they have a hitch in their giddy up. You know what I mean?
So once that patella gets back in the groove, then they'll land their feet.
They're good to go.
Really quickly, with Essie Mae, it's just a weird hair pattern because it's almost like Essie Mae's hair has grown into a hoodie.
Yes.
Is that?
Yes. It's amazing.
Wow, you are so, you are just so adorable. Angela, thank you for sharing Essie Mae with us. Courtney, thank you, sir.